Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Age of Empires 2. I am Rueful, playing this game for you. Woo! We return to set about our means of to bop the man. Which is definitely going to involve some boat work. Hey, you wander that way. See how that works out for you. Alright, back to the boating. We are gonna make our way up here to take some islands. Mostly because they're going to provide us with some additional resources, which we will want. But they will also serve as a launching platform of sorts. Where are you going? We'll never understand the unit pathfinding in this game. Probably will never want to, either. This is seriously the only RTS I've seen where I tell a unit to go in this direction and it immediately starts moving in the opposite direction. Alright. Have we got any idols? No. Most of them are down here on the gold. I'll leave those two over there to finish up that patch. Meanwhile, you guys are going to come on an adventure. I want you to unload there. It'll have a couple of purposes. One of them being to claim all this fish. Which, of course, is going to necessitate the need for a secondary dock. I want you to build there. The rest of you should build the castle. That way, once you're done with that dock, you can set about building that castle. I do need to keep an eye open over here, just in case of a sudden... Just in case of trebuchets and the whatnot. Jerks! Alright. Let's actually have you lot start by I want you to actually come up here and just patrol and make yourself into a target. I really don't want that fire ship. Get him, guys! He'll show that wall what for! Speaking of showing things what for... I'll dump off up here. I want you guys to not be where you'll be made into a target. What am I up to? Oh yeah. Boat! Where are me peasants? You two, garrison into there, get out of there. And put together that camp. Oh yes, you. Don't be up there. Might as well use this while it's here, I guess. Alright, let's set about actually making a nuisance of ourselves. Take this, Venice! Hey guys! See ya. Get him now! Take the sea from the Venetians. A great brutal forest, if I must, which I must. That actually frees up that island. So we can see about actually making use of it for our purposes.
Ha! on the potatoes.
Up here, we have the walls of Venice. And, well, this tower here counts as being inside the walls of Venice. So, you might be able to guess where I want to build my wonder. Definitely want to make sure the cannons and galleons are forcing anything to come through the war galleys. What are you shooting at? Dangerous up there, after all. Venice, of course, has a lot of boats. Go figure. Alright, I definitely want you to deal with that castle. Since I need you guys out of the way. That takes care of those for now. care of that. Well, the Venetians really want to go fishing, don't they? The way! It's dangerous over there! University. I was hoping that was our siege workshop. That's the siege workshop. We cannons! Where are you going? Please don't go close enough to draw the ire of that tower. Yeesh. Let's rebuild that. Here comes Henry again. Alright, I think we've opened ourselves up a large enough safety net, so...
That's weird. Where's my other transport ship? My other big transport ship, that is. I have a whole bunch of tiny ones. You know what? You're a big one, you will do. Let's get us some gold! Let's move functionally all the villagers. Here's my other big boat of idols. There's my other big boat of idols. towers.
The might of the Holy Roman Emperor.
Hoorah! So, what were we up against? Well, yeah, Green has quite the setup just to lay siege to us initially. But, simply by relocating across the river, we were able to dodge most of their advances. And then take hold of, and abuse a crippling weakness in the Venetian city walls. They don't cross the water. Anyone else, we'd have to fight our way through the walls. Which, wouldn't have been pleasant. And then, of course, we had good old Henry the Lion. Let's see what becomes of him after this.
Henry the Lion was immediately banished to England. Separated from his wealth and army, there was little more he could do to plague Barbarossa. After 6 campaigns down to Italy, Barbarossa was weary of crossing the Alps. The fighting ended with the signing of the Treaty of Constance, which said effectively that the Emperor and the Pope were equals. It was a tenuous peace, and one that seemed unlikely to endure, when suddenly the Pope died. The new Pope was less interested in squabbling with the Emperor than he was in events down south. You see, the Europeans were being driven out of the Holy Land. It was time for another crusade.
Seems he'll be back to tangoing with the Saracens, but, I don't remember seeing the forces of Barbarossa whilst we were working with Saladin. I wonder why that is. Well, maybe we'll find out. Or maybe I'm just misremembering. Could go either way. But that will be a tale for next time. We'll see you then. Later.